welcome to the RPG Blender, where we give lesser played games or forgotten settings the roll the dice they deserve. I'm your host, Game Master George, thrilled to welcome you to the next chapter in our adventure. Our heroes have found their meeting interrupted, but can they match wits with these new arrivals? Find out as we explore a new land of power and ancient secrets in Exalted Arguments. Welcome to the RPG Blender. I am, of course, your host, Game Master George, returning with our players to the world of Exalted. So, without further ado, let's introduce these players. Please say hello to Craig.
Howdy, howdy, everybody. This is Craig, a.k.a. Dirham Barath. And a fun fact about Dirham Barath is that Dirham is 32 years old.
Fun. Okay.
Shut up! Shut up! That's what you get. You get that he's 32 years old. You get a little more picture to who he is in his character and whatnot. And you learn a little more. You love a little more. Or you hate a little more. I don't know.
Okay. And all nice, warm, and toasty in his blanket over there, we have Greg. Say hello, Greg.
Howdy, howdy, everyone. It's me, Greg. I play, of course, everyone's favorite psychopath, Adramalic. fun fact about Adramalic is he was very close friends with a servant in his family's house who was in charge of the stables by the name of Onimaeus. And their bond and friendship kind of influenced Adramalic's worldview about the relationship between servant and master. So that's where he gets a lot of his kindness, I guess, from, but not quite kindness, just more like...
Kinderness?
Yeah.
That's what tempered
There's a respect. There's an understanding.
It's what tempered the cynical cynic nature.
Yes, mm-hmm. The cynical cynic. That's
a way of saying it.
Nice alliteration. That was good.
I tried for a third word and failed. Is this character still alive?
Adramalic doesn't know because he left
okay.
Before then.
All right, and then we have Rich. Say hello, Rich.
Greetings, everyone. I play Smiling Mountain or Rakim.
It is Smiling Mountain. It is not Rakim.
Rakim was a fake name that they told me that I've only called him.
And what is your fun fact?
Let's see. Fun fact about Smiling Mountain is that he is almost, because he has been Rakim for so long, it's just starting to feel supernatural to become Rakim.
How dare you fall back on that? Get away from that. Get away
it
from that.
It was one day. It was one day.
But not to us. To us, it was many days.
Get away from that. Shoo away from that name. Shoo away from it.
All right. Well, previously, our heroes awoke the morning of their meeting and attempted to plan what they were going to say. They then sent out Adramalic to scout out the location, make sure it was safe. He then noticed that there were already people lining up. When he returned and delivered that information, they rushed to get their spot in line. They found themselves sixth, however, and not wanting to risk missing out on their chance to present their case to the council, they began practicing their smooth talking to make their way up through the line. They were able to make it past the first person, however, at the second, they began to realize some of the potential fallout of their plan to send the barbarian horde further upstream and toward their, for some reason, beloved city of Nexus. They then did a complete 180 on their plan. stupefying me and probably throwing their own logic in a blender as they ran forward. Product placement there. And then made their way into the council chamber, where they found before them the seven members of the council and began to state their case, trying to feel out the members to see what might affect them, what their opinions were, what avenues would be good approaches. And as they were doing so, eventually another door opened and in walked two well-dressed women who, walking in, issued their challenge to the council and to the others for throwing Rakim's hastily dropped coat back at him. Now, I have a question.
Uh-oh.
Is that cloak still the tapestry that you got from the dream?
No. That's not okay. A cloak. That's actually balled up on my back.
Oh, so much better.
That's okay. Like stuffed into the bag, right?
So it's exposed currently?
No, it's like wrapped.
Wrapped in itself. itself? Like you rolled it up, but it's still...
Yeah, yeah, I rolled it up.
Okay, but it's visibly attached. Okay.
Well, is it, does it seem like it's, is it seem like it's made of like material that might get messed up in the rain and stuff? Because if so, then I'll put it in some canvas. If not, then yeah, it's just wrapped up in itself.
It's a part of like the tapestry of like fate. If that thing gets messed up by... If it, no, what I'm saying is if it gets messed up by rain, yeah, some tapestry of fate.
That's what I'm thinking. It's not supposed to leave heaven.
Well, you know what? A lot of things, but look, if that's going to mess it up, oh, God, if a little water on it messes it up, whatever. You know what?
Bad craftsmanship there, heaven.
Yeah, fate's arbitrary. That's all I'm trying to say. Fate's arbitrary.
All right. So my second question is for all three of you. What is the lower of your resolve and guile?
Oh, geez. Well, of course, we'll figure that out.
I'm bad at guile.
How to do that.
I know I'm bad at guile. I don't remember what it is, but I know.
Where even is guile?
Yeah, what is our resolve?
Guile has to do with manipulation, and I'm bad at that.
Guile is indeed to do with manipulation.
What is resolve and what is guile?
Let me give you the calculations. Sorry, Greg. The numbers are starting early. Guile is manipulation plus socialized divided by two.
It's rounded up. My socialization
plus socialized divided by two.
Okay,
cool.
My
got
guile
it.
Is one.
And what is the other one? What's resolve?
Resolve is wits plus integrity.
Integrity divided by two.
All right, my resolve is two, so guile is lower.
My resolve is two. My guile is one.
Hey, high five.
Guile yeah, right? Three, resolve four.
We're not so different after all.
So, yes, I think that they, yes.
My read intention is seven, though.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's good. All right, so with the 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, that definitely beats that. So, do any of you have an intimacy toward the realm, either positive or negative? An intimacy that deals with your opinion toward the realm.
Probably not.
I have an intimacy.
As part one of this effect is a read intention to find out that information.
I have an intimacy towards reclaiming my birthright, which is ownership of the house, but I don't think that's...
towards the realm specifically.
Okay, no. Nothing.
Basically trying to, when she made her speech about the protection of the city and of the realm, she's attempting to do what you're doing to them and read your response to this thing. So, do any of you have any kind of intimacy toward the realm?
No.
Okay. That is step one. Step two is she is attempting to provoke a positive intimacy toward herself in this moment. You can choose to spend a willpower to resist that intimacy straight out. Otherwise, you will gain a minor positive intimacy toward her.
Yeah, I'm gonna not do that.
We're attracted to her? Like, we're more willing to listen to her? And...
Yeah, it's she comes in and she gives an impression that because we're like, stuff is...
Not too bad.
Yes, it doesn't... It's not necessarily a sexual attraction. It's... it could be...
A cut of your jib.
Mm-hmm. Could be respect. Could be style. It could be... Respect.
Literally anything. Or you can spend a willpower to resist it.
Oh, I'll man. Spend so a willpower.
Yeah, willpower is like the currency for fighting.
This is our social HP.
Which makes you, Mr. Cult Leader, better at this.
It's true.
Yeah, I have a cult of personality. I have extra willpower. Yeah, I'll spend a willpower to resist that. I feel like that's probably worth resisting because it'll make it easier for her to persuade me down the line.
What do we know? It's our first social encounter.
I don't know anything, but if I do know one thing, I'm not going to give them the advantage the first attack.
Oh, man.
I don't care if it was like a throwaway attack. I'm not gonna let her feel like she's got anything on me.
Okay, so with that, we were up to Adramalic. Adramalic, these two new challengers have just entered the arena.
What can I do again, George?
You can talk.
Talk.
And then based on what you talk, you might be reading their reactions to what you say. You might be trying to instill, like they did, an intimacy in somebody. You might be trying to persuade them to take some action. It all depends on what you say.
Might be trying to goad them.
Yep, might be trying to goad them into attacking.
I don't think I'm good enough for that.
I've seen your work. So.
Just play your character.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. But do remember that for some reason they're in the oppositions.
Right.
I will also note that it is perfectly acceptable for you to now feel threatened and begin getting those 5 motes back every round.
Oh yay!
I do feel threatened. Yes.
Yes. Those motes. I figured as much.
Yeah.
When you're talking to the mortals, but But now that there are these two people,
yeah. Are these
of course,
like, do you know if they're dragon blooded?
You do not. But
okay. Maybe that's something that I want to kind of find out. So, man, how am I going to roleplay this? Brain's not working today. Okay. Adramalik will still lounging on the sandbags, kind of lazily glance over and like flick his wrist. Like,
and who are you over there? You represent the realm. Where do you come from? What is your purpose here? To aid against this impending horde?
Do you direct it at one of them in particular?
Right. If I direct it, it's more effective.
Shotgun or direct?
I'll direct it at the one who just spoke. Because
there's a sneaky one. There's a quiet one.
I am Sinis Lenawe. I am a scion of the realm, and I am here to protect this city, and make sure that it does not fall to these hordes.
What's your sister's name?
It's not. It's not.
No, I did not. Yeah. Not that cruel right off the bat.
It's not Lenawe.
Hello, fiance.
It's Genesme, but
I got a lot of names written, and I don't know what they're for.
Crap. Okay. I'm screaming internally.
Okay, give me a read intentions if you would like to try to determine if she's lying or if you have any kind of...
Don't have any tricks, so sure. Let's go with read intentions.
Okay, what read is intentions that? Is perception socialize.
Sinis enters the field, eh?
Oh, God, okay. I might as well pump this, right? Because...
Well, in order to pump it, you would need the excellency in socialize.
Oh, all right.
Is that one of your favorite abilities or cast abilities?
No, it's not.
You know it's not.
I predict much social expenditure of XP following this event.
Oh yeah, it's gonna social expenditure is on the rise.
That's a big fat zero.
All right, so you can't quite gauge any response from her, though she does meet you in the look you directly in the eyes as she speaks to you.
I definitely break eye contact and begin like glancing back at the hooded mask council.
Okay, so we go into the next round. So in the interest of keeping this flowing and effective, what I'm going to do is I will allow you guys to combine your efforts for each round. So you'll be able to assist each other, one person making the final round, the final roll of the round. Okay?
Sounds good.
Sure.
Makes sense?
Yeah, I wasn't going to contribute anyways, so this is excellent. Hey,
you stop.
So your rolls will now be able to contribute extra dice to Mountain when he makes his roll at the end of the round.
Yeah,
this will allow
us
to have a little more of a free-flowing conversation as we go through it.
That makes sense. That makes
a lot of sense. So, because now there's actually somebody to talk back to you rather
unfortunately
than just you guys giving arguments. So, Mountain.
Well, first we're going to talk amongst ourselves. Sidebar.
Oh, yes. Sidebar. This is your sidebar moment.
Why are they here? Why are they against us? This doesn't make sense. The only reason I can think of them being here is to try and gain a stronger foothold here.
The realm desires control over everything, and my house is part of the realm, no doubt currying favor with the emperor of some kind.
So the question is let's try and get that out of them. Is why exactly they are here? We are proposing.
Well, they mentioned that they're protectors of the realm, and they're here to respond to the dangers. Right? That was the gist of what they just said.
It was indeed.
So they must know about the Horde, and
it's a century-long feud. It would make sense that they're more than educated.
Seems odd that they would come this time, though.
Well, perhaps. If things are escalating, and this has been an arms race for 100 years, perhaps the realm is looking for their window in. This crazy. Could be said window.
Or it could be because they want the war to happen, so that way they can be those heroes. So us asking to peaceably make that not happen may be of disinterest to them.
Either way, N'Chara, in theory, will then need them, finally.
So we continue on with our plan, and we make them expose themselves as bloodthirsty assholes.
I would say so. Their distaste for them and them trying to make N'Chara bend knee to the realm, even though they wish to not conform, is to our benefit.
All right. Do you wish to start and I will anchor? Or vice versa?
Sure. Let me...
Do you wish... again, I can start and put us on the path and make them answer. So, for example, if we say we have believed we found a peaceful solution, and then let them say they are for war, goad them into it.
I'd love to hear more of their cards before we mention our plan.
Then perhaps we can simply ask, maybe you can simply ask what they propose, since they have come in opposition to what we are proposing in their very positioning in here. And then I will again slam down at the end.
Very well.
Yes, worth at least a tentative approach to begin.
Yes.
Sure. All right. Break. And we turn back in a poised and cinematic positioning. And Dirim will just take a look across the way to sort of take in both of the two individuals, the representatives. George, is there any way for me to sense if there's a similar, I don't know, power that I have? Because now I have interacted with, I guess, at least three different forms of Exalteds, as well as the emissary, my own magical power, demons of different varieties, even getting a sort of sense of a tether to a lunar. So my perception of the I guess the supernatural that exists here, is there any way for me to try and gauge in on that in relation to them to try and hone in and see what I'm dealing with?
There, I mean, like, I know you could have a charm that would allow you to do that, but otherwise, unless an exalt actually begins spending their peripheral essence, there really is not a way to tell them apart from a normal person.
Okay, that works to our benefit too.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it does, very much so, because if they are dragon bloods, they're not illegal. They can use their powers.
Right. Okay. So DRM looks over to the two individuals, takes a step forward. So one representative speaks for the both of you. I presume you have come as protectors of the realm. I'm presuming then that means you're aware of the current dangers that N'Chara faces. Is that correct?
Of course we are aware of the dangers that N'Chara faces at this moment. The threat of this barbarian horde, as well as the rumors of anathema in present day within the city, have risen concern within the realm about the safety of N'Chara. And thus it is our duty to report here and to make sure that the people of N'Chara are cared for and able to weather any coming storm.
So then, what do you as a protector claim to bring forward? N'Chara has been defending for themselves very heartily and successfully for about a century now. You intend on doing what exactly?
N'Chara, as is evidenced by their need to call in outside assistance, is in a place of particular threat against these hordes. Further, there are none outside of the Immaculate Order who are more versed in dealing with anathema. We come here out of our sacred duty, not only at the request of N'Chara, it would be at the request of the world to see that any such threats are removed.
So your plan here is force.
I have yet to meet many anathema who willingly surrender themselves. But if such were to happen, of course, we would not need to resort to force.
Yet your original statement did not mention anything towards a peaceful resolution, which your force could come at the cost of many, as you mention anathema being such devastating forces in this world, yet here you are deciding to meet devastating force with force.
Yes.
There are innocents here in this city who would suffer.
Perhaps, but they would suffer worse if the anathema were left untethered.
Hmm.
Adramalic, do you want to hit the remote? I give Adramalic like a little nudge. I'm like, you gonna say anything? You could.
Oh yes, no, that sounds like a jolly plan. I mean, you know, kill a few civilians. You're cool with that, right? And he will glance over at the silent, maskless faces of the people. Just, you know, people to die for the realm. It's all good. I mean, I'm sure, you know, if you dealt with this correctly, you could avoid force. But no, that seems like the right way to go about it.
And tell me, what would be the right way to go about dealing with anathema and a rampaging barbarian horde?
Well, meet them out in the field, of course. If the realm is here to protect the city, they should intend to keep the city standing.
Did we state that we wish to fight within the city?
Well, no, you didn't tell us anything. I mean, my friend here very plainly asked you what your intentions were, and you kind of wormed your way around it. Really, kind of not cool, if you ask.
And what is your name?
Really of no concern to you.
You can give her your name now. It's not even your real name. You nudge me when you want me to go, buddy.
Oh, Adramalic will nudge Rakim. His mouth is very pursed, and he looks very angrily at.
I understand because they said their name was Sinis. That's why I'm like, whenever you're ready, buddy. I will look very plainly at the two in the other circle, and I say, I'm sure everyone here is very appreciative of your sacrifice and your arrival in this city in order to hunt down the forces and beasts that may beset this city. I am not sure that they appreciate the insinuation that the city cannot handle itself and has not been able to handle itself. Asking for aid in an empire in which you are clearly a part of, I do not think is something that should be frowned upon. After all, we are all, and I look at them, each other's strength. And so in being each other's strength, it should never be a question of, oh, well, I'm giving this to you. It should almost be as if this is just an extension, should it not? So it is not given, it is the expectation. Just as if I was to say, this river is the lifeblood of this area, and I just kind of pontificate on what I said earlier about the river being the lifeblood to the cities and everything like that, that all of those things are very connected and therefore are very important to make sure that everyone stays safe. I'm asking for aid among the river would also be, it would be no shame in such a thing. There is no weakness in this because we are all so connected. And we should never let the honor in what we've built or the pride in what we've built be lessened by what should be freely given. And I look back at the people who are next to us and I look at the council. So I'm directing at the council. I am trying to invoke pride. So essentially, if they have any kind of pride or they don't like to feel weak, I am trying to invoke that against our speaker friends.
Okay. Well spoken words, my friend. To ask for assistance is not weakness, and it is the responsibility of those who have the strength to offer it to those who ally with them. Nachara is part of the realm. It is not weakness for them to accept our assistance, and it is our responsibility to provide it. And may I ask, who are the three of you? I have given my name, and my companion is Cesus Nachalsi.
Shoot, he's given us names.
Am I from Cesus?
Son of a bitch, you don't have to ask.
Am I from Cesus? am I from Cesus?
That's your choice. Are you from Cesus?
I don't think you are. Aren't you from?
No, I'm from like Norath or something.
Did you choose
Kathak? I'm from the military.
Kathak. Yeah, I thought you chose Kathak.
Yeah, I'm Kathak.
We had like
okay,
the
yeah,
weird,
yeah. We're Kathak.
Weird callback from my. What was that name again? Cesus?
Cesus Nachalsi.
Cesus Nachalsi.
Nachalsi.
I butchered my spelling of that.
Sure, we all did.
I'm pretty sure I just wrote Cesus Kentucky or something. I'm not sure what just happened. I literally will never be able to read that back. I am Rakim of the Mountain. This is gonna smash him.
And this is
I'm gonna introduce everybody, but I'm taking I as Rich. I'm taking my time because Smiling Mountain has much better brain power than I. Fuck, what was your fake name? I don't even remember now. You haven't used it in so long.
Rap? Oh, wait, no, it was Kathak Lau. Kathak Lau.
This is my friend, Kathak Barath. And of course, our companion. And I will just let you say your own name, because again, it's not your real name. So I'm kind of
yeah.
like...
Adramalik. Adramalik has like a little bit of a flair as he says his own name. At your service.
Oh, no, I hear the dice.
Yes, you do.
That is my name. Whether or not they try to read whether or not I'm lying, it's my name.
But it's your name now, so honestly, it's not a lie.
Yours is not a lie. What is your guile there, Mountain?
Well, I don't have good guile, but I do respond to both those things. That's why I gave them.
But they're still not your name.
What's really a name?
They're not your
we
name.
We just established in the intro mine, that he thinks Rakim is his name.
I did! That was my fun fact!
mine is definitely a lie, though.
Yes, his is definitely a lie.
You didn't say it. He said it.
I did say it.
He's still lying.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, but he might have forgotten your name. It's a very forgetful
My guile
name.
Is three, but can I pump that?
Am do I allowed to pump? Have, so, do you have...
my social is absolutely one of my favorite.
Oh, you have the socialize expertise?
I do.
Okay, then yes, you can. It's two motes per plus one that you want to give it, and you can give it up to whatever your normal pool is.
Yeah, so we're going to give it, we're going to put four and give it two.
Okay.
Which brings us up to a solid, because it's divided by... Oh, no, it's not divided. I have to do it by two because it's divided.
Mm-hmm.
So then that brings it up to five. So it's not, okay. It's still not impressive because I'm not a liar.
Better than one.
Okay. Well, Rakim of the Mountain and Kathak Barath and Adramalik. It is a pleasure to meet you all. And may I ask what your intention is here before the council? Because it seems that you speak of similar goals to ours. To ensure
confused.
The protection of this city.
Our intention, plainly, is to find out what the barbarians want and stop this once and for all, if it is something that we can give them. And if there is anthema around, I'm bad at saying
you pronounce
this
it correctly, I know. you okay. In character pronounce it correctly.
thank you. If there is that among them, then it would be easier to parse them out if we can get the horde away from them. It limits the destruction that we need to invoke on the city.
I see. A plan with sound judgment behind it. Yes, give the barbarian hordes what they want and they will go away. Sensible. And then she turns away from you.
Ooh.
That sounded sarcastic.
So let's get those rolls for this segment of conversation.
Cool. So what are we throwing at all this?
Throw your...
You're adding, because I can't stunt.
Your charisma presence to
or
give to
bureaucracy. Or no. Writing, or...
if you were writing, then yes, writing, but no, those were very...
Linguistics.
Actually,
one,
wait,
two,
no,
three,
both of yours
five.
Were very investigative, so I'll give you the perception socialize.
Nice. That's better.
Not and yours, Richard. No, obviously.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah.
And so I throw those, and then my and then successes give him I give
your
to him.
Successes. Yep.
Oh, crap. Okay.
Good. You're good. You're fine.
Come on, dice, work with me.
I got, for perception, socialize, 2 successes out of my 3.
All right.
Hey, what happens when you botch an assist?
We're going to say it probably subtracts.
Yep.
Okay, cool. Hey, I botched.
How many ones did you get?
I got 2 ones.
Subtract 2 ones. Subtract 2 dice.
How many did you give me, Adramal?
Two successes.
All right, whoa. You're rolling on your own.
I really needed those.
I told you, man. I told you.
No, it's fine. I got 3 tens, but I only got 4 total successes. So that's 1, 2, 3 tens and 1 success for a total of 7. Okay. But I rolled virtually all my die tens, which is why it sounds way worse, because there were a lot of dice in my hands for only 3 to come up.
Okay, then let me update these things.
Hooded Lady's freaking me out.
They're all freaking me out.
Yeah, Hooded Lady has said nothing.
Yeah, that's why her name is the harder one to pronounce. It's C or whatever.
I kind of want to.
Cesis, yeah.
Cesis,
desist. You know, am I right?
Yeah. You guys could also spend your turn to make knowledge checks to try to gather information based on names, Mr. Intellectual.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it.
I'm sure that you have something clever that you can do here, Adramalic.
Yeah, can I do something related to my house, because I feel like I would probably recognize who this was if they were like a first or second cousin once removed.
I mean, yeah, you certainly can. Yeah, you can give me on your turn, obviously, okay. On the next one, you can spend some time in deep contemplation as you think upon your life, and with difficulty, of course.
with great difficulty.
Mm-hmm.
Oh man, I fucked myself.
No, I think I fucked you, but
yeah.
That's fine. I'll admit it.
I mean, we chose to be talkies. We could have been like, and now we kill everyone.
We're trying to keep people alive, and that's in character for all of us.
Mm-hmm. So. You got to follow that narrative.
Exactly. Yep.
Okay. I have updated the field.
Mm.
And the other thing that you can do also on your action is to do a read intentions to try to discern what one of those upside down tiles is.
Mm.
Or more if you were to do a shotgun blast of them.
Yeah, okay.
All right, time for your sidebar.
I think I'm gonna go on the attack against the ladies.
I agree,
because that's what I did last turn. I was trying to make them be like, look, like they're trying to say you're weak and you're not weak. So I think we should kind of
Dirham like gives Mountain a very knowing look and says, how are you feeling as far as your reserves?
Good. I feel and I put my finger on my pulse and I say, feeling better now.
I mean, our reserves,
I understand what you mean.
Yeah?
I'm feeling better now.
Okay. You just give me the high sign. If that seems to not be the case, I can do something.
Understood.
But don't let up.
I will not let up.
Even if it means stretching yourself.
Can't stretch myself here, and I rub my forehead.
I know in that respect, but I mean internally. Push your limits, I've got you covered.
God, Adramal, do you know anything about this lady?
I have to think about that. Her name rings some sort of bell in my mind, but I'm not sure what exactly I could tell you about her.
All right.
I'll have to ponder on it for a moment.
Let me know.
Slack for me. I'll let you know what I find.
You're of benefit regardless, friend. And I will then turn away from my companions. I will then pick up my coat and put it on my arm, and I so careless with other things that don't belong to you. And I then put it on my thing.
We treat things with the respect they are shown originally. I see you had much respect for your own coat when you tossed it over here into the dirt.
I didn't know you were present when I moved my coat in that direction. I shall keep in mind.
Oh no, you misunderstand. I do not take offense for you throwing the coat to my area. Instead, I question the respect you've shown your own possessions. How can we expect you to respect the possessions of those gathered here when you are so careless with your own?
Similar to your disregard for the lives here.
We have shown no disregard for the lives here.
I would disagree incredibly that you disregard for the lives here, as it is that I have suggested a way that these people can peaceably potentially get rid of the barbarians once and for all, rather than fighting over and over and over again. Perhaps this is not a position of peace that you wish to see them in. Is this the case? Is it perhaps that you cannot bear to see anyone wiggle out from underneath your toes? Yeah, I'm digging into an intimacy here. I'm trying to be like,
yep. Oh, I gotta pull out the guns now. Okay, here we go.
Darren will also just say, kind of looking more at the council, Representative, I don't believe we need to waste any more time talking about a coat before the council. and he just looks at them and gives them like a...
Oh, I would agree. It was silly of someone to bring that up in the first place. A coat. A mere coat. How could that possibly translate into a city? Meanwhile, no, these conversations, these accusations you levy at us, have we not already stated that, yes, engaging the barbarians outside of the city would be preferable?
When I stated that it would be preferable...
No, actually, you didn't state that. You didn't actually state
that. We actually did, 100%, and the DM will check the recordings.
They said, oh, we didn't say what our plan was, but nonetheless, mm-hmm. It's irrelevant.
It was said after the fact of us asking what your plan was and us making the point that meeting them outside of the city would be a preferable choice. So yes, after we mentioned that was a firm course of action, you said we would do that. So thank you for listening to my suggestion.
A poor general states his plan to random individuals in a city.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Looks to the council.
I then do just continue to press on with the, we have a way of potentially, and I'm not saying that it is going to work, but there is a potential path forward in which we have the most peaceable solution, a solution in which keeps the citizens of this great city, this powerful, noble city, safe once and for all. And instead, you would simply kick the can down the road to further generations?
No, why? We would not. Your plan is to allow the barbarians into the city to take what they want.
Did not say this?
Oh, was your plan not to find out what they want and then give it to them? Is your plan then
who
to give
that
it to
them? Who said that was to let them inside of it? So you're putting words
so
in my mouth.
You're going to give them what they want outside of the city.
If so long as everyone on the council agrees, so that why would we not? But first we would have to find out what they want and then negotiate with them appropriately, hopefully letting them leave the city for all time and actually allowing you to do your job. So is your job to stop the anthema or is your job to keep the city under heel? Which of those two things is your job?
Our job is to go and destroy these barbarian hordes. When we are finished here, they will not trouble the city again because they will be gone.
Their
years of predation upon this city. You forget this. You, the outsider, you do not belong here, and I think you should leave.
Yeah, hit me with them charms, girl.
Oh yeah, that's exactly what's happening.
I knew it.
All right.
I actually have a specialization against this kind of
thing. Oh yeah, you do. 100%. You are the right person for this to target.
Because I have Deft Official's Way active currently. Mm-hmm. Is there anything I'm getting off of these two in regards to that?
Sure. What does it
give you? Wow, I forgot that was good.
Yeah. What does it give you?
Deft Official's Way. I can naturally sense who to talk to in order to produce results, who expects or is amenable to bribes, which functionaries are actually useful or friendly, and which are officious tyrants abusing their meager silver of power. And I can add my bureaucracy score to read the intentions, action of any ability, so long as it helps in producing a desirable bureaucratic result. Yeah. So, which is on page 284.
Just read that through one time and like one piece at a time, and I'll tell you what, if anything, applies.
Okay. So it can do the following. Mm-hmm. Can naturally sense who to talk to in order to produce results.
That would be the one that you were talking to right now.
Makes sense. Who expects or is amenable to bribes?
Neither of them.
Excellent. Which functionaries are actually useful or friendly?
Useful would be both of them. Friendly would... is it friendly in general demeanor or friendly toward you?
That's a great question. I'll let you rule.
You would have gotten this impression when they first walked in.
Sure.
And at that moment, friendly, yes.
Okay. We clearly have changed that. And which are officious tyrants abusing their meager sliver of power?
Neither.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, neither are probably bad people.
Cool.
Good. Oh, no. What do we do?
Good is all in perspective.
Good is
all
in perspective.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Cool. Thank you. Sorry about that.
Nope. No problem. Okay. So let's see what happens here.
Okay.
So this is targeting your resolve. Your against taunt does apply, obviously. So what is your resolve? Don't tell me until after I roll it. Never mind. Don't tell
you
me until
after I roll it.
Okay.
Come on, mountain. Stay like the mountain. Don't hold back, buddy. Don't hold back. I got you covered.
I don't know if I'm allowed to pump at one point. Should I pump before you tell me the result?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to pump two in.
Okay.
Attaboy. Burn it. Burn it. Don't let her
that's
get
gonna,
you.
That's going to be from personal, not from pref.
Okay. And the total here, 7.
Well, I am so fucking lucky I pumped. I have 8 because of the not to be goaded, I get +2 to my integrity, which then brings my resolve up.
What?
By
no. One.
Oh, it just gives me 1?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I knew it was going to give me 1 to my resolve, but it halves it. That's why I said.
Wait, what? Okay, so what's your base resolve?
4.
Base resolve is 4.
And not to be goaded is 5. 1, 5, mm-hmm. And then I just put 2 into it.
Which is 7.
Seven.
Oh, no. So
does that mean he wins? He wins in case of ties, right?
Attacker wins ties.
No!
Yep.
I thought I had two in there. Dang. Oh, well.
Nope. Yeah.
Might be.
Okay. Let's see what happens.
So
nothing good, probably.
Well, the only thing that happens is that you must react with anger.
Okay.
Which you were pretty much going to do anyway.
I was generally pretty good at keeping my cool.
He was getting bubbly.
Well, because they were sarcastic with me. So I was like,
yep. Okay. So what is your response?
Do they have any response to what I've been digging into their intimacies?
What have you been digging into their intimacies?
When I was like, you're just here to keep these people under heel.
You could make me a taunt roll of your own.
Gotcha. What would that be?
That would be charisma presence.
Yay.
Ooh, really?
Mm-hmm.
That we're good.
No, actually probably manipulation. Sorry.
Oh, hey, whoa. Why are you doing this to me? Why are you doing this?
Because it's by definition manipulation.
That's fair.
But I'm not manipulating. Again, no, it is manipulation. I can't even argue that. That is absolutely fucking manipulation.
Just pump it. Yeah. Just pump it.
I can, but it's not as easy to pump as my socialize or anything because they're not as high. I'm not. Rakim is not a naturally manipulative person. Mm-hmm. He's a passionate person, but not manipulative.
Just do it.
And to be clear, your attempt is to needle her and provoke some kind of response as about that.
Yeah, so we're both being dicks. Yeah, we're both trying to make each other angry. That is absolutely the the intentions of both of our attacks is to make the other person look like an asshole. And we're both succeeding.
As the cheerleader on the side, does he get a stunt at all for his excellent banter?
That's a good question.
I didn't give them a stunt either. Would you
okay,
like
okay.
Nah, if we're going right, stuntless, we'll go stuntless. We'll go stuntless.
Yeah, for now.
We'll remember stunts
next time.
I think it's fine for it to be stuntless because we're probably just, because of the dialogue, it's probably just going to be a very consistent two dot versus two dot. So it's better just to wash it, I think.
Probably.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Eight. Jesus.
My man.
Okay, and what was your statement?
Basically, I was like, are you here to save them? Because it seems like you're just here to keep them under heel. So I'm trying to literally make them just be more honest about their intentions, because their intentions with the realm, whether they want to really say it or not, is they might be here to help, but they are absolutely here to establish.
You impugn our position here. We have come here to protect this city, to protect this bastion against the chaos that is to the east. These forces, if you do not crush them here, what will happen if they move beyond this city? This city has stood as a bastion for how long? For a century or more. If this were to fall, if things were to go out of hand here, what might happen next? Nathir, Nexus, Lukshai, these cities may not be aligned with the realm, but they are still bastions of civilization here, and we must not allow them to fall to these barbarians. We must not allow the people, the advancements, to be sacrificed in some unproven hope of a peaceable solution. A firm hand must be taken.
Of course, the firm hand that the realm always takes is that it. We just punch everything into the ground and hope that nothing sprouts in afterward, that there's no resentment, because it's been working for 100 years. You hear that, Nachar? Everything that you've been doing for 100 years, the realm could have just swooped in at any point in time and made it all better at any time. Let's all give them a big round of applause for showing up a century late. Please, everyone, our saviors.
Adramalik is full on slow clapping.
Or perhaps we can actually try something that may work. We can try and see and intuit what our enemies may be thinking, may be feeling, and turn them back. Perhaps bring them into some kind of civilization rather than just writing them off for all time, because that is what the realm does, is it not? Write things off for all time?
And you have met these people? Do you know what they want?
I don't know, but I'm willing to ask before I put them to the sword. And I guess that is the difference between you and I, is that I have hope and I have faith in these people. And I point, like, my arm toward Nachara. I have faith because I have done it hundreds of times before. I have faith because I am here now to help them. And I have faith in the others that are out there, that they may be swayed, that there is something to be gained, that there is something to be learned, rather than just marching steadily off of a cliff into the abyss of chaos.
You hear that, Council of Nachara? You're saved now. This man is here now to protect you.
Well, it's better than what you've been doing for the past 100 years, isn't it? Isn't it a good idea to have a new insight?
Actually, also, can they do their roles from last round?
Because yeah, this is the same like round. This is the same round. But
this feels like a new round. We're
These
now
were
new
the
arguing.
Responses to your
Oh, now we're being angry
roles.
At each other. Okay. The,
yes. you guys can give me your intelligence rolls, though. Your lore intelligence rolls.
I'm so good at that.
If you have any stunts, you can do them.
Remember that one cousin with that list?
Stunt that memory.
Yeah, stunting memory.
Yeah, Adramalik will look back into his memory of being at court with his father and mother, and meeting with the other members of the extended family. Most prominently sticking out is this one time they were all having like a beach holiday together. And he's like, oh, definitely remember seeing her there. So I would roll. What kind of stunt do I get for that?
I'll give you a $2 because I'm feeling generous.
You're a kind man, George.
I don't, man, memory stunts are the weirdest freaking thing in the world. Sure. As Dirham just studies Sinis as she is going on her tirade, occasionally looking over to the council to give like a calm sort of look of, wow, this is getting crazy, huh? Before returning back, making a point that he's not like adding into the sarcastic applause and things like that. He's pretty much mirroring, in a sense, the other individual on the other side as she is staying calm and watching and whatever. Or maybe she isn't, I don't know. But she seems to be the step behind. Dirham is also doing the same, but using cursory interaction as far as response and reaction to what's going on. But studies her and thinks back about his time and his lectures with his family and the understanding of the other households and whatnot, the notable individuals, as well as the annals of history of all of the individuals who have interacted in the lineages of the household, for anything that clicks with who this is. And in general, protectors of the realm, if that is even a position or if that's just a grandiose statement that she's making. He's just checking all the boxes for like, where does this click?
Okay. You can both give me your rolls with two dot stunts.
I got a 3.
Okay.
I got an 8.
Okay. With a 3, Adramalik, you're able to confirm that you've heard this name. You've never met them before, but you've definitely heard the name spoken. Okay. With an 8, Dirham, you begin thinking back to your days when you were part of the Immaculate Order, when you were studying there, and you do remember hearing about when you were nearing the time when they were, when you were nearing the moment when it was pretty certain that you would not actually ever receive the Blessing of the Dragon. You do remember hearing about a relatively newly exalted, or rather chosen group, a bonded kinship, that they received the blessing very closely together. It was a strange event. They were childhood companions, the five of them, and they then, when they went out into the world after their receiving of the blessing, they did become a more effective hand of the Immaculate Order. They were a bit harsh dealing with people who they felt had harbored anathema and things along those natures, but they never caused undue collateral damage or destruction in their wake.
Harsh, just, and restrained.
Mm-hmm. It's a good way of putting it.
Receiving the blessing, was that similar to what Mountain and myself went through before we went on our quest?
No. When I say receiving the blessing, that's when they were blessed with the dragon blood powers.
Yeah, but
so they pretty much exalted.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, interesting.
So you can recall now this name being associated with it, these two names.
Okay. Do I remember? No. That works. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Yeah, got it. Thank you.
You can have your sidebar as they take theirs.
These fucking bitches.
Honestly, I think I do remember that one from House Sinis. She was mentioned to me on one or two passing occasions. Quite the bitch, indeed.
Okay, not even your own family likes you. Got it.
They're both blessed, as far as dragon blooded is concerned.
Of course they are.
Ah, that's what explained by my hair is raising on its ends.
Mountain definitely seems more agitated than usual.
I'll say this, as far as my recollection goes concerning her activities, I believe that she is sort of black and white as far as justice is concerned, but she does not care to do it incorrectly. The idea of damages done while exacting justice, whatever that may be, is certainly an insult to her character, potentially theirs.
That would explain why she's upset.
The error of her ways.
That explains why she is upset.
Correct. Whether or not there's something to make of that, I don't know. But she is dutiful, and as far as the two of them, their characters are genuine. They mean to do what needs to be done. Unfortunately, what that means is I believe they both genuinely believe in the cause of the realm and the Immaculate Order.
They're stably.
They drank the juice.
As we all have.
What juice are we talking about? There's a juice you drink?
We'll teach you about the juice later. For now, whatever we can make of them. If we choose to twist the knife, the name of the game, I surmise, would be pointing out the devastating dangers behind using the might of the Immaculate Order in the realm, whereas our strength here is finding compromise.
Should we mention that we know that there is an anathema in the Horde? They believe it'll be a triviality.
I think we actually did mention that.
Heard whisperings of anathema.
No, I think we...
They don't have the full picture.
They heard whisperings, and that may be because of... And Endirum points, taps himself on the nose.
Well, and luckily there is one, so...
But that being said, us being able to say that we have made peaceful contact with a representative may be of value. Another angle may be mentioning... Here's the thing. They want might to resolve this issue. I think that there is a means for compromise here, but if we let them get their foothold here, there will no longer be. It will be us acting on our own, Nachara falling in line with the realm. So I believe that takes a couple of cards as far as dialogue off of the table. If they hear about an individual such as Roxy, that will be one that will easily be spun in a very ugly manner.
Agreed.
So we need to be careful about that. But I think that utilizing the time that we have, or as long as we have, is important, and finding out exactly what's going on here. A means of reason so that there's no longer suffering.
Yes, I agree. We have to spin it where violence is always an option. It does not have to be the first.
Exactly. Exhaust the rest. Their means is a dangerous path.
Yes, so I will begin readdressing the council now that she has made a fool of herself. Ha ha ha, getting all mad. Not cool like me. You say with my hoarse voice.
Yes, some water.
You got it. You got it, Mountain. You're doing it.
Yes.
Pats him on his arm. I'm going to stay quiet during this next part.
You're going to keep thinking on things? I look at both Adramalic and...
Adramalic, I might suggest that you stay on the offensive, but if you can glimmer anything else, more power to you.
I will do my best.
So sidebar over.
Okay.
There will always be time for a war. There will always be time for violence when they arrive, whether it is days before or moments before, whether we meet them on the field or the walls. There will always be time and a place to fight. However, there is very few times in any of our lifetimes that we can step back and see that there is a time to speak, a time where real peace can be managed, regardless of who it's through. And I ask that you look inside of yourselves and ask, do we need to sacrifice our lives? Do we need to sacrifice anything? And I look at them all very poignantly, and then I look obviously toward the two from the realm and then back at them in order to accomplish this. And if we do not need to sacrifice, then why would we? Let us try to speak. And those who would dissuade us from speaking, even knowing that to take up arms is always an option afterwards, an option that I will gladly participate in no matter what, I am here with you, Nachar. I have chosen to fight by your side. I have chosen to do this because I see promise in your city. I see the splendor in your city, and I believe in what you are now and what you will be later. So allow me to do this. Allow us to speak in one voice and say, what is it you truly want? Let us find out. And if all they want is violence, then we will gladly give them violence. I have no problem, and I point over toward people, with them offering their aid and us defending the city, whatever it takes. But there is no reason to sacrifice before it is necessary.
Council, she has visibly gathered herself.
Yeah, we both, yes.
Council, despite our harsh words moments ago, it is clear that we both seek the same, the perpetuation of Nachara. However, I would ask of your history now, tell me, what is the history of this conflict with these barbarians? On that first instance, did they talk? Did they ask for anything from your council, from your city? Or did they raid? And did they attempt to take? If it is the latter, then what makes us think that they would do any differently now?
Blah, 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 blah. Yes. Barbarians can't be reasoned with and all that. Yes. Yes. It really is surprising how naive you really are. You come in here with your brute force trying to smash down a door when much slighter touch can pick a lock. Honestly.
And Adramalic will sort of roll his eyes and gesture to number two. Like, can you believe this person?
I fucking love this out of character because I was being respectful, being like, I'll let you talk, and then Adramalic comes in and he just Adramalics the fuck out of that and just chef's kiss.
I'd also like to say, just while this is happening, Darum will give a affirmative pat on Smiling Mountain, and instead of doing anything to help with this, I would like to use my essence lending method charm.
Ooh. Oh god damn, please, yes.
Juice him.
And I will rejuvenate some of his motes by giving him mine.
Okay. Oh, thank you.
Your apt analogy, your demonstration of the knowledge of subtlety is quite admirable. However,
I try really hard not to laugh at both of those statements.
How inaccurate it is, yeah.
No, both yours being like, oh, thank you very much.
However, it is not the city of Nachara who asked for this conflict. It is not the city of Nachara who brought it to the gates. It is not the city of Nachara who drew first blood, and is not the city of Nachara who first refused the right of speech. It was the Broken Horn tribe. Regardless of what they seek, they chose the path of blood.
Oh yes, 100 years ago, I'm sorry. Do you know the people who did that? Are you friends with them? Have you spoken with these people from 100 years ago who made this conflict first in existence? The perpetuation of the years and years of fighting is just nothing more than a novelty at this point.
Then why did they not
honestly, the fact that you haven't
words,
considered
why
trying,
did they come with a horde?
Because that's what they've been doing for hundreds of years. If you've done the same thing for hundreds of years, you can't expect to suddenly change.
Well,
look
then
at
it
yourself
doesn't
right
much
now
matter.
As you come here, coming with the sole intention of just attacking the tribe. That's what you've been doing for hundreds of years, isn't it? That's the whole fate of the realm. Honestly, it's kind of interesting. I wonder what Nachara was like more than 100 years ago. I wonder if the realm considered them nothing more than mere barbarians and savages. I certainly hope their opinion of you has changed as of now. And he looks at the council as he says that.
Well, as you state, these barbarians come with a horde because that is what they know, what they have done. So it doesn't much matter if we know the ones from 100 years ago now, does it? Because as you state, they're the same.
They're not the same.
No, they're just
he's
following
being
in the footsteps of the people.
Oh, so he's just a simpleton. Understood. And turns back. And now he's targeting the taunting on you.
Shame. I'm gonna fail that.
Mountain, you gain.
I fucking love that she's targeting him, though, because I'm like, that's great. Now she's not fucking targeting the council. Mm-hmm.
Smiling Mountain, you gain 8 motes back.
Oh, no, this is a flurry.
Oh, my man.
This is a flurry. She takes penalties, but she gets to do 2 different actions.
Ooh. Is there any way I can bolster Adramalic?
Do you have any charms
words
that will let you do that?
And by the way, if those motes put you above your motes, you can keep them until the end of your next turn.
That's great, but they don't because I've been using motes like crazy. Mm-hmm.
Don't worry, buddy. I got you.
That's why you giving me 8 was great because it resets my last turn. Oh, wait. I already used Harmonious Presence, I think.
Did you?
Thought I did. It's my presence charm. Let me go back through my notes here. I used my manners and I used my... Yeah, Harmonious Presence is the one that I did. My bad. But it should give... Oh, wait, it's just me. Never mind. Didn't do anything.
Okay. So, Adramalic.
I fail.
I mean, you don't roll, so it's fine.
Oh, what is your resolve?
Yeah.
Resolve is 2.
Oh, okay.
I fail.
Okay.
I'm mad at her, or whatever.
Yep. You choose to react with hostility, which can be join battle or actual, you know,
yeah,
words.
Like I did, yeah.
Rakim, what is your... of note, as she finishes her statement and turns back to the council, you can see that her body almost begins to be outlined within here. You can see the glow of red surrounding her.
We're making her mad! She's blowing through a lot!
Bonfire is what she's doing.
No, this isn't bonfire. This is just...
This is an effect based on what she's doing?
No, yeah, this is glowing. This is the glowing level. Bonfire is the top level. If it gets to bonfire, it's bad for everybody.
But she's powering up.
Mm-hmm.
I do kind of just quip back. I say, so sarcasm now is a tool of simpletons because she literally was just sarcastic a second ago.
Okay, what is your role to these people?
My role to the council is literally just, you know, save your forces. Like, I no matter what, it's a save your forces. You either care about the people or you care about your position. But no matter what, those are 2 things that I hit in that statement, which is, you know.
No, I'm asking what is your actual role?
Oh, I'm rolling the socialize and everything toward the council. So I'm trying to...
What's the number?
Yes, what's
the
number?
Oh, the number! That's a horse of a different color. 1, 2, 3, go. And then I'm going to add...
Attaboy.
3 motes to it because I feel more invigorated. Ooh, we're probably going to need it. Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 from the 110.
Okay, what is your reaction, Adramalic?
Oh,
you bitch!
Yeah, like... basically, like, this is going to be so fucking bad, but whatever.
Hey, that's
simpleton,
fine.
Eh? Simpleton? Can't even recognize your own flesh and blood and you call me simpleton. Utter
Thank you so much for taking the time to enjoy our show. Come back next week for the next part of our adventure, or join our Patreon for early access to the next episode, as well as our Patreon exclusive campaign of Rippers. If you like our content, consider supporting the channel alongside our first patron, Bubble Dirt. But of course, don't forget to check out our tutorials and video plays on YouTube at The RPG Blender. If you want to stay up to date on our releases, you can join our Discord. Check the description for a link. Don't have Discord? No worries, find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at RPG Blender. Or subscribe on your podcast app of choice. Music is The Punk Rock Show by My Free Mickey. Copyright 2012, licensed under Creative Commons Attribution License. Thank you again, and remember, there's gaming outside the Forgotten Realms. Sorry, I'm calculating out what these people think.
No worries.
I got you.
I'm running through 7 NPC reactions in my mind right now, seeing what happens.
I don't see what the problem is.
Yeah, no. I can't even do one right now.
Thinking for 7 people as one person? What's plus the 2 who are in an aggressive debate? No, this seems pretty rudimentary.
Only honestly. One is in an aggressive debate.
Is that sarcasm, Craig? That's the mark of a simpleton.
Sure is. I don't think I've ever tried to present myself as anything but a simpleton.
Okay, you can get your actually well